Wouldn't it be awful if there is actually a way easier way of doing that mission and people are just going to be really angry at us? Me, specifically. But I'll say it again. Technically speaking, not my fault. The game never specified.
Unless they make it explicitly obvious that... Come back later, mate.
Yeah, maybe it did.
Oh,
I don't
it's Robotnik.
It.
Okay, then.
No, it's Kartos, God of Ore. It's brilliant.
I hate that hedgehog.
Snoopinger's usual, I see.
Promotion.
Oh, man. I really want to watch it again. It's a really... A lot of people hate it. I actually legitimately love it.
Well,
Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog. I love it. I mean, it's really good. It's got some really good episodes. There's one which is genuinely amazing in terms of Robotnik had a really good plan. Basically, like, you see, he sends one of his minions to, like, stop planes at the airport. So you're just like, oh, okay, well, that's an interesting scheme. And then, like, he gets someone to do the same to the train tracks, and then someone to do the same to the lighthouse as well, like, messes with the lighthouse. So the boats can't come into the dock. But what he's actually done is, whilst all the minions were there, they were actually there planting bombs so that they would basically go on. So Sonic was thinking, oh, it was this thing, but it was actually another thing entirely. It was basically just a trick. And Sonic basically had 5 minutes to go to all three places and stop the bombs. Which is a really good idea! By all counts, Robotnik should have won had Sonic not gone through the Earth's core to the other side of the world. Yeah, it doesn't make sense. But still, like... It was just like, damn, like, that's an amazing idea. And it was a really interestingly well-written episode because he was just exhausted. He practically died from exhaustion because he had to go to three different places around the world in the space of a couple of minutes. It was just a really interesting episode. They've done some good ideas. It's overlooked, I feel. I feel I might be the only one who feels that way, but still.
Yeah, Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog is very, like... It's very, like... Looney Tunes situational, sort of, unlike Saturday AM, which is like
heavy story.
Heavy, you know, it's got lore. You know, like
that it does.
Deep lore, yeah, deep lore. Like, you know, I saw an hilarious image of like. Elmer Fudd in like an Iron Man suit, and I'm like, where is this from? I feel like I've seen this before. It's just so weirdly familiar. So I just typed it on Google Images, like Elmer Fudd mech suit, and then it's like edgy Looney Tunes or something, and I was like, it came up with like Lunatics.
Oh yeah, Lunatics.
I'm like, oh
yeah.
My, yeah. I'm like, oh Christ, I remember that.
Bugs Bunny built that thing in a cave with a bunch of squats. Why has no one made that joke before?
Yeah, like, and we'll find is like Bane, and he's just like, we need someone at the wreckage, brother. And just throw someone off a plane.
You're a big guy.
For you.
That'd be amazing.
Didn't see the darkness until I was merely a man.
My mommy gave me a half-barrel shotgun.
Yeah.
God fucking damn this level. I mean, I failed already, so... What's the point?
Rare like their minecarts. They have them in Donkey Kong Country. Yeah. 64. Banjo-Kazooie, I think. I don't know, they're just...
Banjo?
I don't know. It seems like it would be right at home.
Probably. I don't remember if it was in Banjo or not.
My minecart levels in Donkey Kong Country are really hard. Not unfairly hard, but I feel like if you're gonna die somewhere, it's gonna be in that level.
Yeah, I failed.
Yeah.
I made it to the end, but I needed 125, so I need to do it again. Hooray! Yeah, you lose points. You lose points each time you get hit, so... I can do it, I just need to not get hit. Lol. But...
Well, ain't that a kick in the head.
Yeah. So what other games are you looking forward to this year? There's quite a few that are gonna be
I'm saving up... to buy Nier Automata on PC.
Oh, yes. Oh, that's
crazy. Yeah, looks absolutely cool. I remember playing the demo and thinking, I mean, usually I give a bit of leeway. I'm like, whatever. Like, I'm quite diligent when it comes to buying games. When I played the demo, I was just like, yeah, I'm buying this. Like,
yeah.
It was great.
I mean, it's Platinum Games, so
yeah,
you expect greatness from them.
Yeah, I'm also saving up for a Switch.
Oh, okay.
All right. I'm going to get Zald, Breath of Nature.
Mm-hmm.
That's got really good reviews.
Yeah, it's interesting. I'm going to say something controversial. Maybe it's controversial as not loving this game. No, way more controversial. Scratch that. I agree with Jim Sterling. I don't think it's a 10 out of 10. I think it's a great game, but the durability is utter arse. Like, I have a giant axe. It's designed for cutting wood. I chop down a tree, like, I swing at a tree twice and it just crumbles. Like, come on. Like, I know it's a game that doesn't necessarily have realism.
That would really get on my nerves.
It's every weapon in the entire game, so get used to that. Like, I know realism is thrown out the window, you know, like, it's not like, oh, it doesn't need to be super realistic or anything. But at the same time, you need a little bit of realism to tether the game to the real world. Like, every game needs an element of it. And it's just not there, and it, like, that, it really bugs me. I get the idea of constantly switching your weapon out, because it's about, like, experiencing and like, figuring out what's good against your enemies, but at the same time, God, I wish they didn't do that. I would pay really good money for them to release DLC that did not have durability. Not even joking. I don't want durability.
And you can't repair them, can you?
Some weapons you can.
But what about the good ones? Like, I mean, like, Axe of the Conqueror and, like, friggin' Master...
Without spoiling it, like, there's a couple of weapons where they, like, they rejuvenate over time, I guess.
Oh, okay.
But it's...
I mean,
it
Fallout
really
has a...
Fallout game, though. But there is a difference.
But Fallout did it right, because, like, it didn't happen so often that it got on your nerves.
Yeah, no, and, this is like every 2 seconds.
Yeah, like, and, like, when it did happen, you'd invest points in, like, a repair skill, or, like, oh, get the jury rigging perk. It's a perk I'd know, like, everyone gets at one point when their early playthrough of New Vegas.
Hmm.
And then Fallout 4 removed it.
Oh, really?
Which is a shame, because... The condition of the gun posed allowed you to, like, alter strategy a bit. Like, if it was, like, below 50%, then it'd get jammed. It was more likely to get jammed, so you'd have to sit through an extra second of animation, which I thought, oh, that's really cool. And then Fallout 4 just didn't do... Like, Fallout 4 is such a love-hate relationship. There are so many cool things about Fallout 4 I like. But... And then there are other things. I was just like, why... Did you not include this? What sane reasoning do you have for not including a system introduced in previous games? Because Fallout 3 has aged like a sack of moldy potatoes, right? And looks like it too. It is like... Whereas New Vegas, I can get past the way it looks because the gameplay is so fun.
Right.
Whereas Fallout 3 and 4, I think 3 and 4 are like really black and white. Whereas New Vegas is my... That's my baby.
Yeah, no, you were streaming that a lot, so...
Yeah.
I can tell you like it.
I just...
Nothing but praise.
I will, my complaint with New Vegas is that, I don't know, if you're not reusing mods, it's kind of aged badly, it kind of looks like arse.
Right.
In some places.
I mean, yeah, but that's just time. Like, yeah. I never complain about graphics and, like, from older games. It's just like, well, that's just a time thing. Like, I can't really get angry at that.
Yeah. And I feel like, mean, Skyrim got a lot of, like, praise when it came out. Like, 2011, was it? Whatever? Was it then?
I think so, yeah.
2010?
I think it was 2011.
Yeah, well, like, I can't shake the feeling, like, it was just so overly mod-centric. Like, if you're not going to get mods for it, then what's the point?
Yeah, I see what you mean. Okay, so that's Rextro. He has an arcade.
Hey,
you need to get a
cool.
coin.
He's like,
you need to get a coin to run the arcade.
So... Oh, he's like a T-Rex, but he's like made of
he's a retro
Fisher
T-Rex.
Price plastic.
He's Rextro.
Yeah.
His name's awesome. A
pun. Retro.
So yeah, we can't do that because we need the coin, which I don't know where it is in this huge level. But still is big. Had you noticed? Like, I want to love this game. I really do, but I can't bring myself to love it.
I just thought of a really funny.
Go on.
I made a funny. I saw this picture. It was like, when you show her, like, the map of Utah or something, and it's like, it's a screenshot from like a porno,
okay.
And it's just a woman like. Obviously, there's no nudity, but it's like some woman like on her knees, and she's like in the subtitles. It says it's so fucking big, right? And like the joke makes out like she's describing the size of the map, but she's obviously not. She's describing someone's phallic member. So I could just imagine like when you show her the map to Yooka-Laylee, it's so fucking big.
Well, it is. Not getting any smaller.
Is that what she also said?
It is, yes.
That's what she said. See, we pride ourselves on good humour
on
this show.
Yes.
Yeah.
We do.
Good quality classic humour.
We'll leave you wet for days.
Yeah.
I don't know why I said that. right, cool. Believe it or not, I still have no idea where I'm going! Can I get up there? Maybe? Oh, he wants to be fed! I can't do that, because I don't have anything to feed you with. Because, you know, this level's huge. How many times can I say that? A lot. Also, I need to backtrack to previous levels to actually progress, so that's cool, I guess. Maybe?
Yeah, I think... The problem is that like you said, there's like too much on your plate. So you've got like this to-do list in your head, right? Mushroom puzzle, right? The ball rolling puzzle. That was too hard. I'll do that later.
Yeah.
I've got to feed that guy something. They should have like had like a pyramid scheme, where like. Do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
You solve one thing, then, I get to do two things. Solve one of those two things, you get to do four things.
Yeah, like,
right? Then
it's just too much.
Yeah, they should have, you know, like, pyramided it out. I can't, you
or
know.
Just, like I said, make, instead of making five huge, huge, huge levels, make 10 to 15 shorter ones. Make it more original. Like, I know it costs a lot more money, and takes a lot more time, but you might get something better out of it. Because it would be better, basically.
Yeah, you'll be surprised. You can really trick people into thinking a game is, like, quite big, even when the maps are small. Like, on the, like, Crash Bandicoot, even though that was sort of, like, I don't want to say on rails, but even though that was sort of, like, on a track.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Like, it's just like a track platformer. It's just like... Like, I don't know, like Sonic, but from a different perspective.
Yeah, it was actually called Sonic's Ass.
Sonic's Ass, yeah. Well, like, without all the... Something no one really talks about a lot in Crash... I really like in the... For PS1 especially, like, a lot of, like, the foliage they have on the side. And just the way they make it look, they just make it look...
Well, I mean, with Crash 2, they found, like, God Particle, which basically allowed them to, use like 10 times more assets than they had previously been able to use, and I think it was basically the first of its kind to be able to use more polygons and pixels, and I think they shared that with Spyro as well. I'm not mistaken. Because Insomniac annoyed up with my place.
Yeah. Alright, buddies.
Alright, I made it up here just fine when I was trying to do the race. Well, now I'm trying to get the feathers. It's an impossible thing.
Feathers. Have you ever used a quill?
I haven't, no.
I have.
I imagine it's great.
It's okay, I guess.
Okay. Yeah, I bet it feels amazing. No, actually. Well, would rather die.
It doesn't feel not amazing. It just, I don't know, it feels kind of cool, but... Well, the thing is, I used to use a fountain pen a lot, and okay. I prided myself on it. I used to love my fountain pen, because it's like the only pen I can actually write with properly, because I used to have, like, dreadful handwriting, right? And then I was like, you know, one day I was just like, I'm going to step up, right? And I don't know, I just kept, like, practicing. I just got used to using a fountain pen, and I really liked it. And then I tried using another pen another time, and it just went, like, it was really bad, like... But now I don't use a fountain pen as much anymore, but still.
I just want this feather. Like, this can't be that hard. Yeah, no, I know what you mean. My handwriting is appalling. It is illegible. You will not understand a single thing that I'm trying to write to you. It is that good.
So, you'd make a good doctor.
Yeah, I would be an amazing doctor. All my patients would be like, oh my god, I'm fine. No, that says you're dying.
Yeah.
No, you gotta learn to read, my friend. It's because of my dyspraxia mostly, which isn't good. But I mean, I've always thought that maybe I'm actually secretly left-handed and was always trained to be right-handed. Because I can do a lot with my left hand.
Oh,
but it's just
get
as good
that as well.
Right.
Yeah.
Trust me,
I know. Hey, I'm all right, lads. Yeah, my mum always said that about me. Like, I was once pouring tea with like my left hand, or I did something with my left hand, and my mum was just like, "What are you doing?" I'm just like, what have I done? What have I broke something? She was like, "You're using your wrong hand." I'm just like, what do you mean wrong hand? Like
yeah, you just... freak.
Yeah. She's just like, I'm just like, what do you mean wrong hand? Like, what's the right hand? Like,
the right hand is the right hand. Right-handed. You right-handed
yeah,
prick.
Like, right-handed. I'm just like, yeah. Fuck right-handers. That's gonna be a protest in like the post-apocalypse. We will no longer be oppressed by the lefties. Oh god, that's happening now. I just realized.
That sums it up.
Yeah. Alt-right, quite literally.
Yeah.
Like, it's a bunch of, like, skinheads who, like... who wear gloves on their right hand.
So, I have a question. Where haven't I been in this level? And where have I been?
Is there a map?
No, there isn't.
That's dumb. Why
I
would
know.
You not have that?
It has so many good ideas, and it throws shit at you.
Oh, look how many items you collect. Oh, I got a 0 out of 1 bopples.
I'm missing 2 ghosts. I'm somehow missing 18 pages and 45 quills. Like,
oh look. 0 out of 1 schmeckles. Like, oh, don't worry. It's okay, go. I've got 155 bazorples. It's fine. You know, like...
But it's just like, where haven't I been? Like, okay, there seems to be some feathers over there, so maybe I haven't gone over there. But, like, I'm only missing 45 feathers. There can't be that much I haven't explored. So where is 18 pages? Like, where? Okay, there's the mushroom minigame I didn't do, there's the Rex minigame, which has 2 in there, there's the seed minigame, because fuck that. Okay, so that's 4 of 18. Where? Where is it all?
There's a second floor.
No, there isn't, because I've expanded the world already. You have to pay more to expand the world.
Yeah, you have to buy the expansion pack.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the expansion that cartridge very... from the N64. You have to just jam it into your PS4.
Yeah.
Hope it works. Oh, what was I going to say? I forget. Good. Oh, no,
something
I know what I was going to say.
Walkthroughs. About 18 pages?
No, oh, I was going to say walkthroughs. Like, because I call, like, new Let's Plays are cool walkthroughs, just because, you know, it brings in more viewers, because people avidly search for a walkthrough, as opposed to a Let's Play, or, like, just whatever. But, like, whenever you don't, like, get everything, or you're not good, it's like, this isn't a walkthrough, because you haven't bought everything, or you haven't done this, or you haven't done that. It's like, well, like, walkthrough means getting everything. Well, technically not. I am walking you through my first experience of this game. That is what I am doing. You can try and twist it to be, yes, it means 100%, but the way I've always viewed it is I'm walking you through my first experience. Like, everyone who does a first playthrough calls it a walkthrough. No one is going to get everything. No one's going, like, not no one, but not everyone is going to get everything. Not everyone is going to know the secrets, because the game came out 5 seconds ago, and they're desperately trying to get your money. Okay, not your money, your views, like... which brings in money. That's why I have a Patreon page, you should just pledge.
Aren't there games where people are only, like, just finding stuff?
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, I mean...
So, like...
That's like, the crux of a walkthrough, really. It's a first-time experience. It's a blind playthrough. It's just not titled as such. But, I don't know, like, it's just been on my mind, because so many people have, like, called me out on it on various things. Like, with Hollow Knight, I didn't do absolutely everything. So it's not a walkthrough, like... But I got, like, most things. Okay, no, I thought I found a secret for a second. I was like, oh my god, it's a thing of it. No. Sadness. Like, I don't know. It just... The future world is harsh, man. It's so harsh. I got... On one of my Crash Bandicoot videos, someone made literally 100 comments. Basically, like, listing something about a proxy server. I have no fucking idea what it was, so I banned them. Actually, I didn't ban them.
Was it spam?
It was extreme spam. So I reported them for spam, but I couldn't even ban them. Like, you know how you can go onto their page to ban them? Somehow, some people have found a way to remove that feature, so you can't even ban them, you can just hide them from your channel, but that doesn't stop them from posting from your channel.
Oh,
so
nice.
It's just like, okay, how the fuck has YouTube managed to find a way, like, how people found a way to exploit this so you can't ban people? That's insane! Like, how is that even a thing? Like, people could just send hatred and racism, and you can't even ban them. What the fuck?
Yeah, people can probably do like saboteurial work, and they'll probably make another account. And, you know,
oh no, making another account is easy. I can make 20 accounts in like 10 minutes if I wanted to.
Yeah, I've made like backups before. And,
yeah,
like,
I've got
5 seconds. Yeah,
I've got backups just in case Persona 5 gets a couple of strikes. Like, post a trailer. No, all those trailers copyright now. Oh, okay. I never saw it coming. Their takedowns were too fast for
eyes. I never saw
it
coming!
Just,
the soundtrack is actually, like... The soundtrack's amazing.
It is. It's fucking amazing. That's the thing with an RPG, though. Like, you need a killer soundtrack. So you're gonna hear that song a million times.
You're gonna hear it all the time. What is it with JRPG battle themes that are so hype?
Right? Yeah.
Never, like, Last Surprise is awesome because it talks about. This is spoiler free, by the way. Don't scream at me, but oh, you can't because the song describes the story and da da da. No, it doesn't. Alright. So, Last Surprise basically describes how you're like, you know, you're sneaking in, you know, you're being real sly, you know, and then boom, that's your last surprise.
Yeah.
I like to think it refers to the enemy's perspective.
Yeah.
Because it's like, You never saw it coming, you know. We know how to handle ourselves, you know.
Yeah.
And like, another example is Xenoblade Chronicles, where it's like the name of this is the best name for a song in a game ever. It's called You Will Know Our Names.
Yes.
And the song itself is fantastic, right? I think it was co-composed by Yoko Shimomura. I'm actually not surprised.
Yes, it was. Yes. I don't know if that song was, but some of the soundtrack was.
I mean, I could imagine her doing, like, music for Guaya Planes, because it's like quite tranquil, and that's, you know, that's stuff she's made before is a bit like that, like Secret of Mana and all that. But anyway, I digress. It's called You Will Know Our Names, and I really thought about it one day. Like, they're basically a group of randos who just met up because for whatever reason they just got caught up in each other's lives. They go fighting monsters, and it always plays when it's like a boss or like an overleveled enemy, and it's like saying, listen, fucko, you are gonna know our names at the end of this fight. You will not forget us, because we're important. That's what it says. And it's just so euphoric. It's just so hyping.
Yeah,
you know?
I think, like, that's a thing, like, not necessarily just music, but, like, the little things. People really just look over. Like, that's a prime example of it. Like, it's actually quite a key, like, thing that people just don't really think about. Like, oh, it's just cool.
Yeah.
Lol, abrupt end. Basically, my microphone died entirely, and yeah, all it is a one-half conversation. For some reason, it didn't even record in the Skype call recorder, so I don't really know what happened there, but you don't have my audio, so just gonna have to end it, and you didn't miss anything. It's basically just 3 minutes. You didn't miss anything. Next video, we'll begin in the first level again, where we rejoin the action. Hopefully there are no more issues.